you're a mentor to so many people. People look at you and they hear your words and they're like, if he could do it, I can do it. But you have an amazing mentor out there that I would be remiss if I didn't mention in this call, the legendary Les Brown. Yeah. Like, how did that come into play?
Yeah, man, that whole story is incredible, bro. And it's a long story, but to kind of just condense it for the sake of time, and if you guys want it, I wrote extensively about that in my book. But yeah, man, Les Brown was a mentor of mine before I even met him. I watched all his videos, followed his social media, studied the man intensively. And from his humor to his voice tone, to his tonality, to his vocabulary, like I really studied the man. And him, and along with a bunch of other, you know, speakers and influences that are out there, but his story resonated with me the most. And so one day, you know, I live in Florida. I live in the Fort Lauderdale area. He was coming down. I saw it on social media that he was doing an event, and it was going to be a free event. So, and this is a good topic right here that I want your audience members to hear, because this is what really chasing your dreams and believing in yourself looks like with what I'm about to share with you. So my wife and I both work in corporate America. He was coming down to do a conference, and it was going to be free, and it was in December. Now, for those of you that work for someone else, you know that you're given what's called PTO, right? Paid time off or vacation time. So most of the time, by the end of the year, most people are already out of vacation time because they've already used it. You know, you get it in January, you got to use it by December. So in December, we didn't have any more vacation time, my wife and I, but we wanted to go see our mentor. So we had to take a day off unpaid, because we didn't have any more vacation time. So we took the day off to go see him, and we took it unpaid. But man, let me tell you something, guys. There's such a power in showing up for life and showing up for yourself that is unexplainable, and you don't even know that something is happening until it happens, and you look back and you're like, oh snap, how did this happen? And it's happening, and it only happens when you show up for life. You gotta show up for life. So we took the day off, and I went with the intent to meet him in person. Long story short, I didn't get to meet him that day, but I met the host of that event who we started conversating. I told him I was a speaker. He wound up introducing me to the CEO of the company that was putting on this seminar. And the CEO told me, check this out, Shawn. He said, hey, I heard you're an up and coming speaker. I said, yes, I am. And he said, well, you know, we're on tour right now, and Les Brown is our main speaker. We're on tour. We're doing a 30 city tour. He was like, our next stop is next week in West Palm Beach, Florida. We're going to be speaking at the West Palm Beach Convention Center. And I said, oh, wow, that's awesome. He was like, are you able to make it? I was like, I don't know. Why? And he was like, well, if you can make it, I'll give you 10 minutes to show me what you got. And I was like, whoa, are you kidding me? I was like, yo, I'll be there. So now, mind you, my wife and I got to take another day off unpaid the following week. So now that's 2 days off, really 4 days off, because it's 2 days for me, 2 days for my wife, 4 days off unpaid in the same pay period. So you talk about a chunk of that money being gone off of your check when you get that check in, plus my son's birthday. My younger son's birthday is December 27th, plus his Christmas time, and this was on December the 15th of 2015. I never forget it because it's a day that changed my life. So he invited me. I go the next week, and I speak in front of 3,500 people. The first time I ever spoke on a scale that large was 3,500 people. So I'm thinking to myself, man, I'm going to meet this guy for sure now, because now I got backstage access. Long story short, again, I don't meet him. I miss him again that day. My friend who's speaking in the Miami Dolphins Stadium down in Miami. Mind you, this is West Palm Beach. This is down now in Miami Beach. My boy calls me. He's like, yo, I'm speaking over here. I got 2 extra tickets for you and your wife if you can make it. And I was a little depressed. I was like, man, I didn't get to meet Les. I was like, I don't know, man, if I'm going to be able to make it or not. I didn't tell him that I didn't see Les, though, but he told me, all right, no worries, man. I got these 2 tickets for you. And he's like, hey, guess what? Guess who's speaking here tonight? I said, who? He said, Les Brown. I said, oh, snap, I'm going to be there. So I fly from West Palm Beach all the way down to Miami, and there I finally met the man, the myth, the legend, Les Brown. I shook his hand. We made eye contact. I gave him my speaker kit, and the next day, that was a Wednesday. The next day, I go to work. It's a Thursday, business as usual. I get a phone call from an odd number. I'm thinking it was somebody I was networking with that I gave them my business card or whatever, and it's Les Brown. He called me the next
day. Himself?
Him himself called me the very next day. And we had about a 45-minute conversation while I was at work. And he was like, oh, I didn't even ask you if you were busy or not. You know, I'm so sorry. You know, I wasn't respectful of your time. And I was like, no, it's fine. It's fine. And ever since then, man, he's written the foreword to my book. I went on tour with him 2 years ago. I went on tour with him, 26 city tour. And we've done so many things together, man. And it's just like, again, it's just one of those opportunities because I showed up. I believed in myself. I was willing to take the hit on my paycheck. My wife and I, we knew we were chasing our dreams. And it was either this or go back to work in corporate America. And I went after it, man. I put all my eggs in the basket and I went after it. And he called me the next day and that was all she wrote, man. And ever since then, that was 5 years ago. We've been in touch. We worked on a couple of different projects together. Like I said, went on tour. And this is from a guy who was born with a sickness from the Bronx who thought he would never be able to do nothing in life that was great. And now I'm here speaking on the same stages as some of the greats. And it's just an amazing thing, man, that goes to show everybody that's listening, man, that if you have a dream and you have a passion, listen, like my shirt says, man, you can't stop until you win. You got to keep going. And I remember, Shawn, when I interviewed you on my episode, on my podcast, when you said you were interning for four companies and nobody was hiring you and you was on the verge of giving up, but you had that I won't stop until I win mentality, and that's how you was able to make it the bad boy. So, guys, Shawn and I are perfect examples, and I'm pretty sure there's plenty of other people that you have access to, whether if not in person, definitely online, that have the same passion, the same dreams, the same goals and ambitions that you may have. And the only reason that they're winning and some other people are not is because they kept on going and they didn't stop until they won, and they keep on winning and they keep on winning. Because once you get that taste of winning, it becomes a habit. You want to win over and over and over again. So you're going to do whatever you need to do to keep that winning streak going, right? The excitement, the energy, the atmosphere, the people that you get to be around, the people that are cheering you on, right? When you're running that race, that triathlon, and you're running and you got the people cheering you on and you feel your whole body wants to shut down and you feel like giving up and your legs are feeling wobbly and you feel like you can't take another step. But that energy from the people cheering you on, like, oh, you're almost there, you're almost there. Yeah, when you get a taste of that feeling, you it's almost like that's what your high becomes. That's what your addiction becomes. You want to chase that high all the time, but this is a good high. This is the kind of high that not only are you setting records for your own self, but you're inspiring and motivating and encouraging everybody that's on the sidelines, that's cheering you on, that's wishing they could be in your position, that's wishing they could be living the dream that you're living, but they haven't done the work that you've been putting in. Right? So you got to put that work in, guys, and make sure that you don't stop until you win. Because if it can happen for me, if it can happen for Shawn, and it can happen for Les Brown and all these other powerful, successful individuals, it can happen for you. You just got to figure out a way to make it happen.
What's up, guys? Thanks for sticking with me to the end of the video. Truly appreciate you. If you like anything you heard here today, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And if you know anybody that can benefit from this message, feel free to share. Peace and love.